sodana sasyam. Namo Skritvahi Maria Varlokiteshvararam Bhava Namo Narakindehi Mahabhaswami Sarva Harhato Shobha Majayim Sarva Sattva Namo Vastava Namo Vagam Havatetu Tadyathaum Avaloki Lokatikratehi Hiri Mahabodhi Sattva Sarva Sarva Mala Mala Mahi Mahi Dindayim Guru Guru Karmam Doro Doro Vijati Mahavijati Dara Dara Diri Nishvaraya Jada jada mama vimana muktilehi ehi shina shina harcham prashari visha visham prashaya holo holo mara holo holo ri sara sara siri siri soro soro bodaya 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 maitraya nara kindi drashani nabaya mani swaha siddhaya swaha maha siddhaya swaha siddha yogeshwaraya swaha nara kindi swaha mara nara Swaha sirsimam hokaya swaha sarva maha hastaya swaha chakra hastaya swaha padma kastaya swaha nara kindi vagaraya swaha mavare sankaraya swaha namo ratna trayaya namo arya valokiteshvaraya swaha umsiryanto mudrapadaya swaha umsiryanto mudrapadaya swaha umsiryanto mudrapadaya swaha Surpass profound and wonderful Dharma is difficult to encounter in hundreds of millions of eons. I now see and hear it, receive and uphold it, and I vow to fathom the Tathagata's true meaning. Namo Shakyamuni Buddha, Namo Shakyamuni Buddha, Namo Shakyamuni Buddha. Namo Sadharma Pundarika Sutra, Namo Sadharma Pundarika Sutra, Namo Sadharma Pundarika Sutra. The Lotus Sutra, Chapter 10, Teacher of the Law, the World Honored One, spoken verse saying, if you wish to abide in the Buddha way and successfully gain the wisdom that comes of itself, you should be constantly diligent in offering alms to those who embrace the Lotus Sutra. If you have a wish to quickly obtain wisdom regarding all species of things, you should embrace the sutra. And at the same time, give alms to those who do so. If one is capable of embracing the Lotus Sutra of the wonderful law, know that such a person is an envoy of the Buddha who thinks with pity of living beings. Those who are capable of embracing the Lotus of the wonderful law relinquish their claim to the Pure Land, and out of pity for living beings are born here. Know that persons such as these freely choose where they will be born, and choose to be born in this evil world so that they may broadly expound the unsurpassed law. You should offer heavenly flowers and incense robes decked with heavenly treasures, a wonderful treasure hoards of heaven, as alms to those who preach the law in the evil world following my extinction. If there are those who can embrace the sutra, you should press your palms together in reverence and offer alms to them as you would to the world honored one. The choicest delicacies, all that is sweet and tasty, along with various types of clothing, you should offer as alms to these sons of the Buddha in hopes you may hear a moment of their preaching. If there are those in a later age who can accept and embrace the sutra, they are my envoy sent out among the people to perform the thus come one's work. If for a space of a kalpa one should constantly harbor a mind destitute of good with the angry look, should revile the Buddha, he will be committing an offense of immeasurable gravity. But if for those who read, recite, and embrace this Lotus Sutra, one should even for a moment direct evil words, his offense will be even greater. If there is someone who seeks the Buddha way, and during a certain kalpa presses palms together in my presence, and recites numberless verses of praise. Because of these praises of the Buddha, he will gain immeasurable blessings, and if one loves and extols those who uphold the sutra, his good fortune will be even greater. For the space of 80 million kapas, with the most wonderful shapes and sounds, with that which is pleasing to smell, taste, and touch, offer amsu to the upholders of the sutra. If you have offered amsu in this manner, and have heard the teachings for even a moment, then you will experience joy and good fortune, saying, I have gained great benefit, medicine king. Now I say to you, I have preached various sutras. And among those sutras, the lotus is foremost. If you wish to put aside all sloth and remittances, you should listen to this sutra. It is hard to get a chance to hear this sutra, and believing and accepting it too is hard. If a person is thirsty and wants water, he may dig a hole in the high plateau, but as long as he sees the soil dry, he knows the water is still far away. Bit by bit, he sees the soil grow damp and muddy, and then he knows for certain he is nearing water. Medicine King, you should understand that people are like this. If they do not hear the Lotus Sutra, they will be far removed from the Buddha's wisdom. But if they hear this profound sutra, which defies the law of the voice hearer, if they hear this king of the sutras and afterward carefully ponder it, then you should know such persons are close to the wisdom of the Buddha. If a person expounds the sutra, he should enter the Thus Come One's room, put on the Thus Come One's robe, sit in the Thus Come One's seat, confront the assembly without fear, and broadly expound it for them, making distinctions. Great pity and compassion are the room, gentleness and patience are the robe. The emptiness of all phenomena is the seat, and from that position one should expound the law for them. If when a person expounds the sutra, there is someone who speaks ill and reviles him, or attacks him with swords and staffs, aisles and stones, he should think of the Buddha, and for that reason be patient. In 1,000, 10,000 million lands, I will manifest my pure and durable body, and for immeasurable millions of kapas will expound the law for living beings. If after I have entered extinction, there are those who can expound the sutra, I will send the four kinds of believers, magically conjured monks and nuns and men and women of pure faith, to offer amsu to them. To offer arms and cause them to listen to the law, they will lead and guide living beings. Assemble them and cause them to listen to the law. If someone thinks to do evil to the preachers with swords and staffs or with tiles and stones, if I dispatch persons magically conjured who will act to guard and protect them, if those who expound the law are alone in an empty and silent place, and in that stillness where no human voice sounds, they read and recite the sutra at the time, I will manifest my pure and radiant body for them. If they forget a passage or a phrase, I will prompt them so they will be thorough and effective. If persons endowed with these virtues should expound the four kinds of believers and read and recite the sutra in an empty place, I will enable all of them to see my body. And if the expounders are in an empty and silent place, I will send heavenly beings, dragon kings, yaksha spirits, and others to be an assembly and listen to the law. Persons such as this will delight in expounding the law, making distinctions and encountering no hindrance. Because the Buddha's guarding keep them in mind, they will be able to bring joy to the great assembly. If one stays close to the teachers of the law, he will speedily gain the Bodhisattva way. By following and learning from these teachers, he will see Buddhas as numerous as the Ganges sands. Chapter 11, The Emergence of the Treasure Tower. The world-honored one spoke in verse, saying, this holy Lord, this world-honored one, though he passed into extinction long ago, still seats himself in the treasure tower, coming here for the sake of the law. You people, why then do you not also strive for the sake of the law? This Buddha passed into extinction an endless number of kapas ago, but in many places he comes to listen to the law. Because such opportunities are hard to encounter, this Buddha originally made a vow, saying, after I have passed into extinction, Wherever I may go, in whatever place, my constant aim will be to hear the law. In addition, these emanations of my body, Buddhas in number, in immeasurable numbers, like Genji sense, have some desiring to hear the law, and so they may see the many treasures. Thus, come on, who has passed into extinction, each has abandoned his wonderful law. Abandon his wonderful line, as well as his host disciples, the heavenly and human beings, dragons and spirits, and all the offerings they give him, and has come to this place on purpose to make certain the law will long endure. In order to see these Buddhas, I have employed transcendental powers, moving immeasurable multitudes, causing lands to be clean and pure. Leading each of these Buddhas to the foot of a jewel tree, adorned as lotus blossoms, adorn a clear cool pond. Beneath these jewel trees are lion seats, and the Buddhas seat themselves on them, adorning them with their brilliance like a huge torch burning in the darkness of the night, a wonderful incense excuse from their bodies. Pervading the lands in the 10 directions, living beings are wrapped in the aroma, unable to restrain their joy, as though a great wind were tossing the branches of a small tree. Through this expedient means they make certain that the law will long endure. So I say to the great assembly, after I have passed into extinction, who can guard and uphold, read and recite this sutra now in the presence of the Buddha? Let him come forward and speak this vow. This many treasures, Buddha, though he passed into extinction long ago, because of his great vow rose a lion's roar. Many treasures, thus come on, I myself and the emanation Buddhas who have gathered there surely know this is our aim. You sons of the Buddha, who can guard the law, let him make a great vow to ensure it will long endure. Who can... He who is capable of guarding the law of the sutra will thereby have offered them to me and to many treasures. Thus come many treasures, Buddha dwelling in his treasure tower, journeys constantly throughout the 10 directions for the sake of the sutra. One who guards the sutra will also have offered them to the emanation Buddhas who have come here, adorning and making brilliant all the various roles. If one preaches the sutra, he will be able to see me and many treasures. Thus come on, in those emanation Buddhas, all you good men, each of you must consider carefully. This is a difficult matter. It is proper you should make a grave out of the other sutras, number as many as Genji sends. But though you expound those sutras, that is not worth regarding as difficult. If you were to seize Masumaru and feeling it from afar, to the measureless Buddha lands, that too would be not be difficult. If you use the toe of your foot to move a 1,000,000,000-foot world, booting it far away to other lands, that too would not be difficult. If you stood in the summit of being heaven and for the sake of the assembly preached countless other sutras, that too would not be difficult. But if after the Buddha has entered extinction in this time of the evil time you preach a sutra, that would be difficult indeed. If there were a person who took the empty sky in his hand and walked around with it, that would not be difficult. But if after I have passed into extinction one can write out and embrace the sutra and cause others to write it out, that would be difficult indeed. If one took the great earth, place it in his toenail and ascended it to the Brahma heaven, that would not be difficult. But if after the Buddha has passed into extinction in the time of evil, one can even for a little while read the sutra, that would be difficult indeed. If when the fires come at an end of the kapha, one can load dry gas in his back and enter the fire without being burned, that would not be difficult. But after I have pass into extinction, if one can embrace the sutra and expound it even to one person, that would be difficult indeed. If there were to embrace the storehouse of 84,000 doctrines, the 12 divisions of the sutras, and expound it to others, causing listeners to acquire the 6 transcendental powers, though one should do that, that would not be difficult. But after I have entered extinction, if one can listen to and accept the sutra and ask about its meaning, that would be difficult indeed. If a person expounds the law, allowing thousands and thousands, millions, and immeasurable number of living beings equal to Genji sense to become our hearts and done with the 6 transcendental powers, so one might can for such benefits that would not be difficult, but after I have entered extinction, if one can honor and embrace a sutra such as this one, that would be difficult indeed for the sake of the Buddha way. In immeasurable numbers of lands from beginning until now, I have widely preached many sutras, and among them the sutra is foremost. If one can uphold this, he will be upholding the Buddha's body. All you good men after have entered extinction, who can accept and uphold, read and recite the sutra now in the presence of the Buddha, let him come forward and speak his vow, the sutra is hard to uphold. If one can uphold it even for a short while, I will surely rejoice, and so will the other Buddhas. A person who can do this wins the admiration of the Buddhas. This is what is meant by valor. This is what is meant by diligence. This is what is called observing the precepts and practicing Dhota. This way one can quickly attain the unsurpassed Buddha way, and if in future existences one can read and uphold the sutra, he will be a true son of the Buddha, dwelling in a land spotless and good. If after the Buddha had passed into extinction, one can understand the meaning of the sutra, he will be the eyes of the world for heavenly and human beings. In that fearful age, one can preach a sutra. For even a moment, he will deserve to receive alms from all heavenly and human beings. Namo Sadharma Pundarika Sutra, Namo Sadharma Pundarika Sutra, Namo Sadharma Pundarika Sutra. The Artha Prajna Paramita, the Bodhisattva Avalokita, while moving in the deep forest of perfect understanding, shall light on the five skandhas and found them equally empty. After this penetration, he overcame ill being. The Sancharipudra form is emptiness, emptiness is form. Form is not other than emptiness, emptiness is not other than form. The same is true with feelings, perceptions, mental formations, and consciousness. The Sancharipudra, all dharmas are marked with emptiness. They are neither produced nor destroyed, neither defiled nor immaculate, neither increasing nor decreasing, therefore in emptiness. There is neither form nor feelings, no perceptions or mental formations or consciousness, no eye or ear or nose or tongue or body or mind, no form, no sound, no smell, no taste, no touch, no object of mind, no realms of elements, no interdependent origins, and no extinction of them, no well-being, no cause of ill-being, no end of ill-being, and no path. No understanding and no attainment, because there is no attainment. The Bodhisattvas, grounded in perfect understanding, find no obstacles for their minds. Having no obstacles, they overcome fear, liberating themselves forever from illusion and realizing perfect nirvana. All Buddhas in the past, present, and future arrive at Anuttara Samyak Sambodhi. Therefore, one should know that perfect understanding is the highest mantra, the unequaled mantra, the destroyer of ill being, the incorruptible truth, the mantra. Prajna Paramita should therefore be proclaimed. Gate Gate Paragate Parasamgate Bodhiswaha Gate Gate Paragate Parasamgate Bodhiswaha Gate Gate Paragate Parasamgate Bodhiswaha. Namo Amitabhaya Tata Gataya Tadyata Amrita Bhavi Amrita Siddham Bhavi Amrita Vikaranti Amrita Vikaranta Gamini Gagana Kitta Kare Swaha. Namo Amitabhaya Tata Gata Yata Dieta Hamrita Bhavi Amrita Siddham Bhavi Amrita Vikaranti Amrita Vikaranta Gamini Gagana Kitta Kare Swaha. Namo Amitabhaya Tata Gata Yata Dieta Hamrita Bhavi Amrita Siddham Bhavi Amrita Vikaranti Amrita Vikaranta Gamini Gagana Kitta Kare Swaha. For any misdeeds I have caused by my mind, speech, or action, due to my ignorance, greed, and anger, I repent. For any misdeeds I have caused by my mind, speech, or action, due to my ignorance, greed, and anger, I repent. For any misdeeds I have caused by my mind, speech, or action, due to my ignorance, greed, and anger, I repent. Namo Shakyamuni Buddha, Namo Shakyamuni Buddha, Namo Shakyamuni Buddha. Namo Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, Namo Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, Namo Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva, Namo Manjushri Bodhisattva, Namo Manjushri Bodhisattva, Namo Manjushri Bodhisattva. Namo Great Strength Bodhisattva, Namo Great Strength Bodhisattva, Namo Great Strength Bodhisattva, Namo Samantabhadra Bodhisattva, Namo Samantabhadra Bodhisattva, Namo Samantabhadra Bodhisattva. Bodhisattva. Namo Shiti Garbha Bodhisattva, Namo Shiti Garbha Bodhisattva, Namo Shiti Garbha Bodhisattva, Namo Maitreya Bodhisattva, Namo Maitreya Bodhisattva, Namo Maitreya Bodhisattva, Namo Deva Guardian Bodhisattvas, Namo Deva Guardian Bodhisattvas, Namo Deva Guardian Bodhisattvas. I vow that from now until the end of my life and in all future lives until I attain Anuttara Samyak Sambodhi, that I will help all sentient beings in all realms of existence in their suffering. I vow that from now until the end of my life and in all future lives until I attain Anuttara Samyak Sambodhi, that I will help all sentient beings in all realms of existence in their suffering. I vow that from now until the end of my life, until all future lives, until I attain Anuttara Samyak Sambodhi, that I will help all sentient beings in all realms of existence in their suffering. I take refuge in the Buddha, the one who shows me the way in this life. I take